Been a really decent week for both of these teams. City's elite development squad, to give them their official name, but they too, like Liverpool, had quite a few youngsters involved in the squad. A big win for Manchester City as well over Sheffield Wednesday, but they've some defending to do here from Shea Ojo, who broke on the right-hand side. Couldn't really get him a gusto behind his effort on goal against Ian Lawler. But an early warning shot for Manchester City, but they are not resting on their laurels, and they're forging an attack at the other end. Liverpool all out of organisation here. Can he get a cross in from the byline? He can, and it's going to be 1-0 for Manchester City. In the very infancy of this game, it's Thierry Ambrose who's provided the cross, but it was the pace at which Manchester City broke at Liverpool. They had their own opportunity at one end through Shea Ojo, and it was Brandon Barker. We spoke about him in the opening exchanges of this game, breaking away on the left-hand side. He put it inside to Hiwula. He got something on it, but it was a decent finish as well. Manchester City managed to win it back. Liverpool just need to regain a little bit of composure here. Ryan Kent coming back to make up for that astray ball before, but again it's gone by Phillips here. Manchester City are right at Liverpool's heels here, and they can sniff blood again here through Bytyqi. Fancies his chances here on his left foot, and it's 2-0. And Michael Beale will know that this game is far from over yet. Lots of the players not available or involved in the first team here tonight to watch these youngsters play. Liverpool have had a really good spell here. Can Alan Phillips get one back? He can. Good time to score. Seconds before he'd taken a coat of paint off that Manchester City crossbar. Look at that. Brilliant. No more so than this young man. Had the summer of his life, didn't he, going away with Liverpool on that pre-season trip to America, included at the very last minute in that Brendan Rodgers squad. Lots of excitement about this young group of players. The test that is in existence now is to get back into the game. And it's Phillips again! Would you believe it? 2-2. Same celebration. Not the best of connections in truth on the cross that came in. It was a nice dummy as well, wasn't it, by Ryan Kent. Not that he will care too much about the connection on his left foot there. Adam Phillips talked about this threat down the left-hand side before the game. It's a really good cross in. And Liverpool, after all of that good work, have been pegged back again at 3-2. Just allowed that little pocket of space, caught sleeping at the set play. Danny Ward could do nothing about that. Really, really good header. Samad Yesel. It's good feet from Yesel. May take it all away on his left foot. Again, it's a good save, and then cleared off the line by Ashley Smith-Brown. Real sight of those improvements and that rise level of confidence as well from Samad Yesel. City have had quite a bit of joy attacking down the left-hand side. Chance here! And perhaps put beyond Liverpool now. And again, it's Jordy Hiwula who is the danger man, the big number nine. Good technique. Danny Ward left with no chance really. And 25 yards from goal, he's shown already he's got great technique in this game. That could make it safe for City now. Lloyd-Jones, the skipper, throwing a bit of caution to the wind now for Liverpool, the big centre-back, attacking down that right-hand side. Harry Wilson, who's on for Liverpool now. Can Yesel find him? He can. Offside flag stays down, and Liverpool have a third. Good interchange and good intelligence as well from Lloyd-Jones. Is there one last opportunity for Liverpool? There isn't. And Manchester City will go a bit closer to the top. It's been a really entertaining evening, but Liverpool finishing up on the wrong end of a 4-3 scoreline. Finished here, Liverpool 3, Manchester City 4.